Guys, happy Friday. I hope everyone survived the 4th of July, and you're ready for the weekend. I went shopping today for a bunch of seeds. My husband and I started a garden last week, so I'm super pumped to have some time tomorrow to plant some seeds and get the garden straight. But today I wanted to talk to you guys about the new weight classes and picking a weight class. If you are on Instagram or you're a weightlifter, you probably saw all of the posts from everyone yesterday about the new classes and people talking about what class they're going to compete in and just general conversation about bulking, cutting, whatever. And so I wanted to talk to you guys about that. But before I begin, I want to preface that with this is a really complicated, involved decision. And I think that you should certainly consult with your WAD coach, also work with your weightlifting coach about this, and talk to yourself and be honest with yourself about what you want and really the lifestyle that you want to live. Because all of those things should go into picking a weight class. So first, when you are deciding what you should weigh, and I think this applies both generally and for a weight class sport, you need to figure out what your ultimate goal is. So is the ultimate goal to just look a certain way? And if that's your ultimate goal, then I don't know that your weight class needs to be a factor in deciding what you weigh. You should just, get to the weight where you're happy with where you look and then compete in weightlifting or whatever sport, at that weight. You just want to be healthy and active and compete in a variety of sports. If that's the case, then I don't know that your weight class should play a role in determining what you weigh. You should just compete where where your weight sits naturally, and where you feel healthy and you're able to participate in weightlifting and in the other sports that you want to participate in. Where I think that you need to start considering your weight class is if you want to compete nationally. But even so, we'll get to that later. But if you want to compete internationally, I would say definitely your weight class needs to be of greater concern, and maybe you need to have a little more strategy about picking your weight class. So kind of moving forward, I'm going to be talking specifically to people who are trying to compete nationally or compete, at a higher level internationally or, make a team, medal in nationals, that kind of thing. For those of you who are just looking to look a certain way or just kind of like do weightlifting for fun, I don't recommend really stressing a ton about your weight class. I would just compete where you fall. I see a lot of people who, I've worked with and I train with. I train with at the gym and stuff, who really, really cut hard for local meets or cut hard and attempt to make nationals, and they end up costing themselves, 4 to 8 weeks of training time because they cut so hard they make no progress going into a meet, and then they just have this nasty rebound after the meet. And there's a great expense to that of all of that time you're losing. You're losing 2 months of training time cutting really hard for a local meet, and it's not serving you. So just consider that when you are considering cutting weight. I trained with a girl who she walked around, and this was, obviously prior to the new weight classes. She walked around at like 80, 81, and she was pretty lean. She was like 5'10", 5'11". She was tall, and she cut like 5 or 6 kilos, and it was a hard cut. Like she had to cut cutting hard 6 weeks out. And going into a meet, she'd hardly be eating anything. And she would compete at like the American Open Series, but she wasn't in contention for a medal. And I just watched the kind of like rebound after, and it was so extreme for her body, and it would mess her hormones up. And if that's you, I'm not sure that you're pushing yourself forward in weightlifting or in, just strength training generally by going through those kinds of cuts. So obviously like your coach here at WAG will help you do whatever you want to do, and if you want to go into those cuts, we're game, like we'll help you with it. But just consider that. Consider the amount of time that you will be losing doing a really hard cut like that, and kind of like what the return is for you on that. I see that I have a comment. Oh, Megan's just agreeing. So kind of moving forward now, I think you need to consider, where are you currently? As far as, like, you're trying to make, say you're trying to make it to nationals, where are your strength levels right now? So when I started lifting, before I could go to nationals, I could easily be a 58. I walked around like 60, 61, and I was not really, I wasn't overweight by any means, but I wasn't like super lean, and I ate whatever I wanted. This was before I even started tracking macros, and I told my weightlifting coach I wanted to cut to 58, and he was like, that's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. I will not allow you to do that. You are not a 58. And at the time, I thought he was being a jerk, but he really just wanted me, like, he knew I needed more real estate to be the best weightlifter I could be. So he wanted me to just eat and just train and get stronger, because, you know, at that time I wasn't squatting enough to even make it to nationals. So then by cutting just to 58 just because I could was not going to pay off in the long term, you know, if that makes sense. You have to think of the big picture. Like, sure, today maybe you can be, you know, the new 59, or maybe you can be 55, maybe you can cut to these smaller classes, but ultimately, is that your weight class? It ultimately, is that the best thing for your long-term goal, which might be, you know, being the best weightlifter you can be, whatever that is. So consider that, you know, if you're really tall, if you're the tallest girl in your weight class or the tallest guy, you know, maybe that's not the class for you. Like, maybe you're sacrificing gains to be more competitive in the smaller weight class, but you would be better served by training long-term at a higher weight, building muscle at that weight and growing into that weight class. I've been lifting as a 63, you know, newly 64 for 5 years. And I would say now I'm finally actually filling out my weight class. And even now, like, I'm a tall 63 or 64, you know, my husband wants me to just go up to 69 for his, you know, his own personal preferences. But, and you know, maybe in a couple of years I will. I think right now I'm not quite big enough to be a 69, but you need to consider that. Just because you can be super small, just because you can squeeze into that weight class, doesn't mean you should, doesn't mean it's great for you long term. And another thing I would consider is, like, strength levels. And I think for women, I would say, when I would start considering cutting to a smaller weight class is if you're back squatting over double body weight. For men, I'd say, like, probably 2.5, 2.75 body weight. Maybe then going into a harder cut makes sense. If you're already competing nationally, you know, you're pretty good, you're pretty strong, maybe then pushing yourself into those cuts, doing, you know, water loading, saunaing, all that stuff, maybe at that point it's worth it. And maybe it really will make a difference in your standing. You know, if we're talking the difference between, you know, you compete at the higher class and you finish seventh or eighth, but if you cut to the lower class, you're going to podium and you don't have to kill yourself to get to that lower class, then I think that it's worth it. And then I think that's when you have a conversation with your WAG coach about what that's going to look like. But if your strength levels aren't there and you want to compete nationally, you're losing time every time you go through those cuts. Because it's, you know, it's 4 weeks, 6 weeks going into it to make weight, the mental stress of making weight, and then the rebound that tends to happen after a meet. And then kind of on the other side of it is, like, when do I go up a weight class? And I think you look at your body fat percentage and consider that. I like being around like 14-15%. I don't like to be super, super lean. I think that it's stressful mentally, and it is not great for my recovery. Everyone's a little bit different, though. Some people do train very lean and feel great. I think that's something that you need to be aware of. I think that if you're like, if your body fat is more like 18% for women, probably like, I don't know, 16% for men, I don't think that I would recommend going up a weight class, unless there is some strategery there. You know, if there's no one in that weight class and going up is, you know, the difference of a medal for you, then maybe do it. But even then, you don't have to fill out that weight class. I think that's one thing that people, you don't have to get like, you know, super soft to go compete at that higher weight class. You can just be in the middle of it. I know one of our coaches, Alexa, she's kind of like too big for 58, and getting to 58 was super tough, but she's not that tall, and being 63 is like kind of too big for her. So for the past, I don't know, I coach Alexa, so that's why I'm talking about this. Like for the past year, maybe, she's been competing just kind of like 60, 61. And it's been great for her. She's made tons of progress. Like, meets have not been stressful. Like, you can do that. You don't have to fill the weight class out. And you know, with time, you will fill it out. Time being 5 years, though. So just, you know, have that expectation going into it. And then the other thing that I wanted to touch on that I don't think that people consider and they're not always honest about is the mental expense of cutting weight. I always say making weight should not be harder than making lifts. And I see a lot of people, they make making weight harder than making lifts, and they stress so much about making weight. They put so much energy into cutting weight. They don't even think about their snatch opener, which I think is a humongous mistake. No matter what level you're at, I think that if making weight is harder than making lifts, you really need to reconsider what you're doing. Because you're not performing at your best. If you're spending all this time worried about what you weigh. And like a good example is when Adi competed, we competed in the same class. And Adi could get on super low macros kind of for what I think is kind of a long time. And she could go into meets like doing pretty tough cuts. And she's fine. Like, she'll tell you like her best meets were when she was not eating that much. And I know for me, I can't do that. I experimented with like a tough cut, like purposefully trained a little heavy and tried to cut differently. And it was a horrible meet for me. I felt horrible. Like, even my snatches felt heavy and I was dizzy. So that's both like a mental, I think it's both mental and physical. You need to be honest with yourself about what you're capable of. I know for me, I can't cut hard. So I'd plan for that, and I would never cut to a lower weight class just knowing that I just can't handle it very well. And Adi can handle it well. So that's something to experiment with yourself and to be honest about what you were physically and mentally capable of. And all of this to say, everyone's got their own opinions about cutting weight, about training weights, about, you know, what you should cut for a meet, how lean you should be, and it all, you know, some of it, it's all gonna be about your personal makeup. And, you know, are you prone to injury? Are you, you know, do you have a high stress life? Do you travel a lot? All of those things. These are just some points I wanted to kind of like throw out there for people to consider. And the biggest thing I want to say, because I think this speaks to the most people in this group, is if you are just trying to like get onto the national stage, like you're right on the edge of qualifying for nationals, or you're just getting started into weightlifting, and assuming that you're not, you know you're not overweight, I really encourage you to kind of just train at your natural weight. Don't stress too much about making weight. Do not go through hard cuts, and just really focus on getting stronger. Like, weightlifting should not be a sport about being as small as you can be. It should be about being as strong as you can be. So if you think you can be as strong as you can be at this lower weight class, honestly, be honest, then, you know, talk to your coach about it. But if you know this is like something, I'm only going to be able to cut to this for the next 6 months or whatever, don't make those cuts. They're going to cost you in training. Long term, you're wasting time. And it's just not worth it. So that is kind of my two cents. Those were the big things that I wanted to touch on, just because I'm seeing so much floating around out there, and I'm seeing so many people talking about doing these crazy cuts, and I think it's a mistake. I think it's a mistake for most people. You know, if we're talking about going, you know, the difference between like going to the Olympics or not, you know, then let's do something extreme. But if we're talking about you're just getting started, just trying to get stronger, let's not do anything extreme. Let's like really focus on being stronger. So I'll hang out for just a second. There's not a ton of people watching live at the moment, but if anybody has a question, you can, oh, there's three comments here. They used to pop up. I haven't done live in so long, but now it's so weird they're not showing up. I don't know, maybe I'm doing something wrong. I can't see them. What's embarrassing is this is going to live on the page for so long, and it's going to be me just struggling to see comments. I don't know. They're not coming up. So if you – maybe they're just the hearts that people sent. I don't know. But if you have any questions, comment on this video, and I will get notified of it, and I will check back. And just – this is my two cents. I'm a weightlifter. I compete in the U.S. I have a handful of national medals. I've been around the sport for a little while. I've trained with a bunch of different people at a bunch of different levels. And I, you know, I obviously work for WAG. So I like to think my opinion means something. But if it doesn't apply to you, throw it out. Like if anything I said you don't like, does it work for you? Does it make sense? Throw it out. That's totally cool. A lot of this is very individualized. And I acknowledge that. Everyone does it differently. But if there's anything I can help you with picking a weight class or anything like that, I would love to help you. I love weightlifting. So thanks, guys. Enjoy your weekend.